So Rabbi Nachman is saying in Nikutei Moharan, but before of the tshuva, but before that the person is doing tshuva, azay bechinat eye adayin lo echin et atzmo lemehevei ba'olam. The person haven't even prepared himself to have a part in the world. Before you're doing tshuva, you don't have no shayachut, you don't have no connection to the world at all. Before a person did tshuva, he's not connected to the world. He lives in a fantasy, he lives in an imaginary world that he made up for himself. He thinks that he needs to work, he thinks that he's going to make money, he thinks he needs to get married, he thinks he needs to buy a house, he can even think that he needs to do aliyah, he can even think that he needs to live Jewish life and to be frum, and what he lives in a dream. He doesn't listen to the voice of Hashem before he completed his tshuva. The Zohar Kadosh is explaining what's the meaning of the word tshuva. Tshuva means to come back. So where you are coming back to where you've been. So you need to realize that in the end of the tshuva, what you're going to be? You're going to be holy, right? So actually you were holy. And you need to come back to your holiness. To do tshuva, it's not only to fix everything that you messed up, all of your mistakes. When you're going to finish your tshuva process, you're going to become holy. You're going to be righteous. You're going to be even higher than righteous. Because it's written, in a place that Baalei Tshuva are standing, even the complete righteous people cannot stand. Because of their purity, because of the greatness of their level, because what did they achieve? Those Baalei Tshuva. So, the tshuva means that you will be pure. But the Zohar HaKadosh is saying that tshuva means that you need to come back to the place that you started. Where were you started? Where have you started? Where do you think? You started in a very holy place, and you need to come back to that. Means you need to uncover your true self. You need to start realizing who you really are. And that's the mission. The mission is not to change, is not to become, is not to work on, it's not to develop, it's just to come back to your real true self and to understand, who am I? It's just a temporary world that in this world, in this period of time, we have a mission. What's the mission? The mission is only not to forget the Creator, to remember that it's all Him, never to fall in the trap of all of those coverings, of all of those husks.